Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we will be discussing about a very recent current affair, that is India's longest river ropeway. So we will be discussing about it in detail in this lecture. It's a very interesting lecture also. It is both analytical and factual based. We will see what are the facts related to it. Also we will see what are the advantages, what are the impact, or what can be the future impact of this river ropeway. So let's begin the lecture. But before that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel UGC NTA NET Computer Science, please do subscribe to our channel. And also please do not forget to press the bell icon. And if you like this video, please do share this video with your friends also. We are preparing online classes for GATE, NTA, UGC NET and PGT Computer Science. You can avail our online courses. So the online courses, the details of which are available in our website. This is our website, www.digimento.com. You can get the details of the courses from our website, or you can ring to us on this number from where you can get the details as well. So let's begin. Let's see the facts first. So coming to the facts, India's longest river ropeway was unveiled in Guwahati. So the location is in Guwahati. So this is important. Now it is the longest river ropeway. So this is the country's longest river ropeway. In many competitive examinations, such kind of questions are asked in the general awareness session. So it will be helpful for you if you can remember this. So India's longest river ropeway was unveiled in Guwahati. So it's in Guwahati. And it is across the Brahmaputra river. So river is Brahmaputra and it is in Guwahati. So the length of the longest river ropeway, which is unveiled in Guwahati, it is 1.82 kilometer. So 1.82 kilometer by cable jigback ropeway. So the length is 1.82 kilometers. And now regarding the connect, it connects the southern bank of the Brahmaputra. So from the southern bank of Brahmaputra and the hillock behind the Dol Govinda temple in North Guwahati. So this is regarding the connect. It connects the southern bank of the Brahmaputra and a hillock behind the Dol Govinda temple in North Guwahati. So this is regarding the connection. Now, one way ride. So here it is regarding the cost of commutation. So if a person wants to commute across this ropeway, river ropeway, so one way ride will cost one person rupees 60. So one way, if you want to take a one way ride, it will cost 60 rupees, while the fare for a two way commutation will be rupees 100. So two way commutation is rupees 100, whereas one way commutation is rupees 60. Now let's come to the other details like the construction cost. So construction cost is about 56.8 crore rupees and using the Swiss technology. And the work started in 2006, but due to alleged politics, and the project was virtually abandoned after 2011. So basically the work for this river ropeway in Guwahati, it started in 2006, which means it started 14 years back. But what happened is that it got stalled, or the work got stalled in 2011 because of some political indifferences. It can be because of political indifferences between the state government and the central government, or sometimes the local issues also. So due to some political indifferences, the work got stalled. It stopped in 2011, even though this was started in 2006. Now it passes over. So we will see what are the important locations it passes over. It passes over the Mid River Peacock Island. So again, this is important. It passes over the Mid River Peacock Island that houses Umananda, which is a medieval Shiva temple. So it passes through this very historic place, which is a medieval Shiva temple. Medieval Shiva temple means a Shiva temple which was built during the medieval times. So it's a very ancient Shiva temple. It's not a modern temple. It's very ancient and traditional. So The river Ropeway, it passes over the mid river Peacock Island, and in this island is the medieval Shiva temple of Umananda. So Uma is basically Shiva's wife Parvati. So Umananda, so Uma Nanda temple, or which is a Shiva temple. Okay, so this is one historical spot or one very important place through which it passes. Then thousands of people commute every day between the capital city of Guwahati and the town of North Guwahati, where the IIT Guwahati is located. So this is another significance of this ropeway. Now we have seen the connect. So we have seen which are the places this river ropeway connects. So if we talk about the significance, so significance of this ropeway, there are thousands of people who commute every day between the capital city of Guwahati and the town of North Guwahati, where the IIT Guwahati is located. Now, regarding execution of this project, the Guwahati Metropolitan Development Authority has executed this project. So, Guwahati Metropolitan Development Authority, GMDA, Guwahati Metropolitan Development Authority has executed this project. Now, the current travel options between the two banks are by ferry. So, this is like if there is no such a river ropeway, the current option for travel for the people from these two locations, from Guwahati to the northern Guwahati town. So, this is only through a ferry. And this takes around 30 minutes of travel time. So, 30 minutes of travel time by ferry. And by road, there is a bridge which connects the North Guwahati and the Guwahati. And it will take 1 hour. So, by road, through a bridge, it takes 1 hour. Okay. Now, a very important significance of this river ropeway is that it cuts the travel time between the two banks to 8 minutes. So, see, if people use a ferry, it takes 30 minutes, half an hour. If through the road, through a bridge, by road if people travel, it takes 1 hour. Now, the travel time is cut short to 8 minutes using this river rope. So, this is the most important significance of this river rope. Okay. Now, let's come to the advantages as well. So, these are a few advantages of this river ropeway. First one, it provides a breathtaking view of the mighty Brahmaputra. So, it can promote tourism. So, tourism, as we said, this is across the Brahmaputra river. So, it's very beautiful. So, the tourism development can take place. So, it will help in promotion of tourism, cultural activities. Even we can bring in religion and culture. Why? Because as we said, in the midway, there is a Shiva temple. It's a medieval Shiva temple, Umananda temple. So, because of all those things, there is significance in terms of tourism, that is commercial significance, cultural significance and religious significance as well. So, this is one important thing. Second one, this is connected to it. It promotes tourism in the state. So, tourism will be promoted. Then, one of the most advanced and longest river crossing aerial tramway systems in India. So, this is one of the most advanced and longest river crossing aerial tramway system, which means it can be counted in as an infrastructural development or an achievement in the field of infrastructural development for India. And as we said, apart from all these, for the local people, the most important advantage is the cut short in the travel time. So, it will help the local people to cut short their travel time. It will also ease their communication from one place to another, especially because the IIT is located in North Guwahati town. Again, this is going to add. So, there is commercial significance, local significance or regional significance, cultural significance and religious significance to it. So, these are all the advantages. So, this is all about this topic. I hope to meet you again with another interesting topic. So, please do subscribe to our channel if you have not yet subscribed to it. And if you like this video, do not forget to press the like button and do share this video with your friends as well. Thank you so much for watching. I'll meet you again with another interesting topic. Please take care.